In 2010, the government banned the practice of traditional birth attendants as a means of reducing maternal and neonatal deaths. Despite the ban, hundreds of women, especially in rural areas, still prefer the traditional birth attendants to the skilled health workers in health facilities. Speaking at the Intergenerational Dialogue in Amdat District, Dr. Acheng Esther, the Assistant District Health Officer in charge of maternal and child health in Amdat District, noted that hundreds of mothers continue to deliver from traditional birth attendants.
A case in Loro, also some time back, I remember the VHT came and reported in the health facility that they saw a mother pouring blood from like a homestead.
Acheng explained that this has led to increased deaths of mothers and newborns, as well as new infections, especially HIV and AIDS and hepatitis B.
These traditional birth attendants, remember, they are not having protective gears. They don't put on gloves, they don't have aprons, they don't have gum boots. So they just conduct using bare hands. First of all, they don't know the status of this woman. So they end up contracting any disease that the mother is having.
These worrying trends have been attributed to the fact that the district has inadequate health facilities. Amdat District is comprised of 11 sub-counties that are served by only 2 health center 3s plus 1 private hospital. This, coupled with poor transport system, has forced mothers to opt for the traditional birth attendants that are nearer to them.
To recommend that the government considers constructing more health center 3s in this district, Amdat, because we have only 2 health center 3s out of the 11 sub-counties, because each sub-county should have a health center 3. But now here we have only 2.
A few mothers that we talked to confessed that traditional birth attendants are more accessible to them, a reason why they prefer to deliver their babies there instead of walking long distances to health facilities. Susan Ikwakol, a psychosocial support officer working with Action Aid International Uganda in Amdat District, asked the government to ensure the safety of mothers in this region through improving health services. Constructing more health centers and recruiting health workers should be top priority if the government is to save the lives of mothers and babies in the district.
The provision of these services are inadequate. For instance, we have some sub-counties that don't have any amenities.
The intergenerational dialogue organized by Action Aid International Uganda, in line with implementing the 9th UNFPA country program in Karamoja sub-regions, is aimed at eliminating female genital mutilation and provision of integrated gender-based violence services in the district.
2 years, we've actually been able to create awareness amongst these communities on these negative social norms. That's why you find that amongst our interventions, or when we are conducting these activities, for instance, like today we are here to do an activity on the intergenerational dialogues. This is a conversation within the different categories of persons in the community.
The programs are geared towards nurturing progressive social norm change, specifically in the campaign to end child marriages and teenage pregnancies in Amdat, with the support of key community influencers such as Culture Dialogues with Boys, Men, Women and Girls. Report compiled by Rachel Nachuala for the news.